Tonight on the 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown Election Special, John Richardson, Alan Carr, Sarah Milliken, Ramesh Ranganathan, John Kern, Susie Dent, and Rachel Riley. Now, welcome your host, Jimmy.
Welcome to the 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown Election Special, a show about letters, numbers, conundrums and the ballot box. Did you know, for example, a quorum is the minimum number of MPs needed for a vote? And according to Mo Farah, it's also a healthy, low-fat meat substitute. Despite there being 650 MPs, the House of Commons only has 427 seats. So I guess the rest of them are just down the front in the mosh pit. And an exit poll is a poll asking people how they voted as they're leaving the polling station. My exit was polled once. It's actually very painful. Right, let's get started. OK, let's meet tonight's players. First up is John Richardson. John is left-leaning. Left-leaning against the bar, alone, because no-one wants to talk to him.
I love it when you just file them away. Just, OK, that's him destroyed.
And John's teammate, Sarah Milliken. Can't believe our luck. Sarah has three pets. Thanks, pet, sorry, pet, and why I pet. OK, up against them this evening, special guest team captain, Alan Carr. Oh,
thank you.
Alan can't decide if he's left-leaning or right-leaning, and neither can his teeth. And joining Alan tonight is Ramesh Ranganathan. Ramesh is an ex-teacher who believes in transformative politics. He's already changed hundreds of kids' lives for the better when he decided to give up teaching. Alan, if you were Prime Minister for a day, what would you do?
Well, you know what? You know number 10, you know, the door? I'd take off the door and I'd replace it with betting shop curtains. To make democracy look a bit more accessible, but a little bit seedy. What's it then? Do you know what I mean? Yeah.
Okay, so John, if you were Prime Minister, do you think you'd get on with the other world leaders?
I think so. I think they'd like me. I think that'd be one of the few sort of situations where I'd be seen as quite a character. Here comes Richardson with his bloody his cheeky face.
Oh, she'll be having a bloody custard cream at the meeting.
Oh, I'm glad you're here, mate. You really perked the room up.
Sarah, would you get on well with the world leaders?
I think I'd get on well with the French and German ones. But mostly I'd just be asking, like, où est la piscine and that sort of thing.
Tony Edouard or Tony O'Gull?
Gains the immigrant house. You're welcome.
When I do German, though, I start getting felt like, was ist das, das ist gut, ja, ja. I can't help get, you know, danke schön.
It's all going off, is it?
Yeah, yeah.
You're just
I'm learning it from porn, yeah. What's German for my boiler needs fixing?
John, did you once book a hotel room and stay in a hotel on election night so that you could watch it on your own and not be disturbed?
No. I booked a hotel room with a friend. My wife didn't want to be up all night with us. You know what lads are like, watching the bloody election. We booked a suite room. We had a bed each for, like, you know...
Making love in.
For... sleeping in or whatever lads get up to in bed, so we could have done that in it. And then we went to a supermarket and got some, like, microwave meals and some...
There was a microwave in your hotel room?
It was a suite. It was one of those with a kitchenette.
You are so easily impressed.
Well, because I've eaten a microwave meal that hasn't been microwaved and I wondered if that's what you just...
What, like a lollipop?
No, it wasn't frozen. I'm not a monster.
Well,
did you just...
Yeah, just cold gravy. It was just like a stew.
A stew?
Oh.
I was hungry.
Romesh, you work with your mum a lot.
Yeah.
If she was a politician, what would her policies be?
I fear her policies would be very sort of specific to me. Like, she'd have a policy that Romesh should call more. A policy that Romesh needs to shave his beard off. A policy that Romesh needs to lose a bit of weight. A policy that Romesh needs to finally see someone about his eye.
Do you need to see someone about your eye?
I've been to job interviews and that's all they've talked about. I went for a job interview, just every question was related to my eye. She'd be going, so what do you think your five... Sorry, I can't... you're looking at me. and it was for doing trolleys at the supermarket. Generally... I got the job. I did get the job.
What does that other one see? Do you see the...
It's a genuine question.
No, it's really... I'm glad you asked me, because nobody's ever asked me. It, genuinely, it sees a minute into the future.
Romesh, have you got a mascot this evening? What have you brought?
I do have a mascot. It is... it's actually my mother's voting slip.
What now?
Because I don't trust that woman.
To make the right decision.
So I just thought, take the power away from her, she don't deserve it. Her paperwork's all illegal anyway, so... No, I went round her house one day, she's watching Loose Women, and she said, you're not, they're making some really good points, and I thought, this bitch can't vote. Do you know what I mean? That's absolutely no way.
OK, so you got your mum's polling card, excellent. Alan, what have you got?
Well, I was going to get political, but I thought I'm going to use this to name and shame my bloody mum. My mum genuinely bought me this for Christmas as my main present. Do you know what it is?
Is it a butt plug?
No, it's the glasses holder. She went, I just don't know what to get you. I'm like, no shit. Look at it. And she went, oh, it's mobile, Alan, cos whenever you need to put your glasses anywhere, you just put them on there. And I was thinking, when am I ever... Can you imagine me, like, going out tonight in Manchester having a fight? What are you looking at? Yeah, bring it on. Yeah? Yeah? Come on. Come on,
I like it.
I know.
Are you not supposed to put it, though, with, like, the handles there and there, so it's like a little face? Like that?
Yeah, that's...
Now it's a good present.
Oh, my God.
That doesn't look too far from me, actually. Seriously.
OK. John, do you have a mascot?
I am actually awaiting the results of... I've stood in the election for the Countdown Party, which I launched last year to... get Countdown fans voting, really. So I've stood in the constituency of Wet Wang in East Yorkshire, and I've got every hope of getting in with some of my key policies to enhance Countdown.
Well, what are these policies?
Well, obviously, a lot of Countdown viewers are retired, so I bring the age of retirement down to 30. That way, I think a lot more people would watch. Get rid of the letter K. Don't need it. We've got 25 letters. That's round, isn't it, then? You could put that in a nice grid. But 26 is bullshit, innit? And it ruins the little rhyme at the end. Why have we got a kicking cur and a curly cur? We haven't got a sexy S and a spicy S, have we? Change the national anthem just to that. you could have words to it if you wanted to, but...
Do you have words worked out for the national anthem?
You just change them according to whatever the situation is.
Well, here's the situation. This is the new national anthem, everyone.
This is Britain. 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 Oh, I was about to say Britain, Britain, not in Europe now.
I would love us to sing that song to my mum just before we deport her.
George National Anthem, everyone. Sarah, did you bring a mascot with you this evening?
Yes, I did.
Fabulous.
Yeah, he's just there. Hold on a second.
You brought someone on?
Yeah.
Who did you bring?
I brought my little dog. Hello, baby.
And he's tall.
That is a beautiful creature.
What's he called?
He's called Commander Tuvok.
Where's that name from?
It's from Star Trek, but he's a rescue, so it's just his given name. Oh. So you have to keep a dog's given name. You can call a cat what you like, because they don't give a shit. But he's got a present for you.
Has he? Go on, what have you got for me?
Close your eyes and open your hands. Oh. Open your eyes.
That's warm.
Oh, it's it. It's a recent one.
Thank you.
That. This year.
OK, over in Dictionary Corner, it's John Cairns. John, for those that aren't familiar with you, could you tell us a little bit about yourself?
Yeah, well, yes, Jimmy. What you see is what you get with me. I guess my medical records would be... I had my tonsils out when I was 6. My appendix was ripped from me when I was 14. And I was delicately circumcised at the age of 25.
Yeah, you can take those teeth out at the end of the record, can't you?
I tell you, you think that's bad, mate? Last time I was on with him, he browned up.
OK. With John Cairns, of course, Susie Dent! Susie Dent, she likes her men like she likes her parliaments. Hung. And in charge of the numbers, it's Rachel Riley. I don't know what party Rachel will be voting for, but I do know that dress is definitely not conservative. Rachel, do you think you would make a good prime minister?
No, I mean, they start off, they must have good intentions at the start, and then as soon as they become politicians, we all just hate them. And I'm wearing red, like, I'm a Man United fan, so already half the people hate me, then everyone hates math, so that's me out.
I don't want to break your heart about this, but if you're a Man United fan, it's much more than half the people.
Gonna let you go.
Is he all right?
Yeah, I just don't think I can concentrate on my sums. Thank you, Ryan.
Okay, the prize the teams will be competing for tonight is this, the Countdown Portable Voting Booth. Okay, let's count down, everyone. Time for the first game. John and Sarah, you get the first pick of the letters.
Okay.
Please.
Oh, thanks. A vowel, please, Rachel.
Thanks, Sarah.
E. Ooh.
Another vowel, please.
I.
A consonant, please.
N.
Another consonant, please.
J.
Yay.
Did you just say yay because your name begins with that letter?
Yeah, you don't say it a lot, do you? It's nice. Oh.
A vowel, please, Rachel.
A.
A consonant, please.
D.
And another, please.
T. This is
and another, please.
M.
I'll do the next one.
Go on, then.
No, no, you finish this.
Oh, I thought you wanted to...
You finish this catastrophe.
you choose the last
one. All right. Let's go for an O.
OK, and for the first time today, here's the countdown clock. John, how many?
7.
Sarah, how many?
6.
Romesh, how many?
6.
Alan?
7.
You haven't.
I have!
It would be a proper word, wouldn't it? All right, Sarah, what's your 6?
Mourned.
Mourned. Mourned.
Oh, sorry, moaned.
Moaned. Romesh, your 6?
Made it.
You could have had a 9.
Yeah.
John made it.
John made it.
John made it, of course. John, what have you got?
Jointed.
Jointed. And Alan?
Jointed. See that? Jointed.
Oh, same as him. That's convenient.
You saw me writing that down with your left eye as you were writing.
Do you know the thing is, I saw him write down before the clock had started with this one. That's what happened there, mate.
And yet you still didn't get it.
7 points for both teams. OK, John, Susie, could they have done any better?
Yeah.
Thank you.
There was an 8?
Yeah. Dominate. To dominate is definitely the best.
So at the end of that, both teams have got 7 points. Good. Okay, on to our first numbers round. Alan, Romesh, you get the pick of the numbers. Romesh used to be a maths teacher. Pretty easy for you, this one.
Why'd you do this, man?
Well, because you used to be a maths teacher, so I assume you're going to be good at this every time.
Yeah, and I'm not.
Well, I presume you just batted it, like, for a gag, but actually
That's genuinely what my mum thought that after the last one I did. She phoned me and she goes, why are you letting them make you pretend to be dumb? And I had to tell her that was me trying my hardest.
Did you have, like, 4 little ones and 2 big ones?
Yeah, let's do that.
Yeah, yeah.
Please.
2 big ones, 4 little ones. And they are 9, 5, 10, 7, and the big ones, 125. And the target, 339.
OK. And your time starts now. OK, so the target was 339.
Oh! I think I've got 339.
Well, no-one is more shocked than me. Romesh, did you get it?
Have you got it?
No, I didn't get it.
OK, John, did you get it?
No, I haven't got it.
Sarah, did you get it?
No.
What? There's no shame. Alan Carr got it. He's brilliant at maths. Alan, how did you get it?
All right. 10 minus 7 is 3.
10 minus 7 is 3.
Yeah, times by the 100, 100, 300.
300.
Plus the 25, plus the 5, plus the 9.
Yeah. Well done.
Alan Carr!
What? How did I get that?
I've absolutely no idea.
Because normally the numbers, all I hear is la, la.
Can you hear Romesh's mum crying? Thank God for Alan Carr, is all I can say. Thank God. 10 points to your team. So John and Sarah have 7, Alan and Romesh have 17. And here is your teaser. The words are vote arse. The clue is shove it all in. That's vote arse. Shove it all in. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser, the words were vote arse. The clue was shove it all in. It was, of course, overeats. So, Alan and Romesh are in the lead. OK, they've been playing in teams so far, but this game is just for Romesh and Sarah. So, Romesh, your turn to choose the letters.
Could I get a consonant, please?
D.
And a vowel?
U.
And a consonant, please?
R.
I'm just doing it random. Is this?
You know your letters. You're not even doing the right letters that they
what
are.
Do you mean?
That don't even look like a D, and that don't look like an R.
Could I have a consonant? I'm trying to tune out this prick right now. Could I have
G.
another consonant, please?
G.
And a vowel.
O.
Good name for a Hoover.
Dirt ball. Consonant, please.
S.
Vowel, please.
I.
And consonant.
And M.
OK, and your time starts now.
If I was running this show, I know what my first rule would be. Naked Wednesdays.
I think Jimmy could be a politician. That fake smile, those dead eyes, he's got the lot.
Why is Jimmy staring at me like that? Gross. It's like he's mentally undressing me.
There ain't no party like an S Club party.
OK, Sarah, how many?
Five.
Five?
It's a good word, though.
Oh, well, I mean, that's fine.
Yeah.
You're up against Romesh. I don't think you're going to have a problem. Why have you got a pen in both hands?
Because I've been... honestly, mate, the way I've been working on this round, I've been absolutely smashing it. I've done too much stuff in one hand to write down, mate. It's been crazy.
How many?
Well, I've got a safe five and I've got a risky eight.
Risky?
What are you going to go for, the safe five or the risky eight?
Go for your risky eight, then. Go on.
You're going to go for
I'm going to go for the risky eight, yeah.
OK, right, Sarah, what's your five?
Moist. Oh. Told you it was good, right?
That is a great word. Moist rug. Let's just enjoy that for a moment, shall we? Happy election night, everyone. OK, Romesh, your risky eight.
I think this might be a nine, actually.
Stick your mustache on the end, what is it?
Dung riots. As in, there was so much dung, it caused a bloody riot. Oh, my God, I wrote down the wrong letter.
I told you! He's writing the wrong letters now.
Do you know what? I think this has been pretty embarrassing for everyone.
I think mainly you, though, right? Well, it's 5 points to Sarah. John, Susie, could they have done any better?
Well, yes. You could have had two sevens. You could have had tourism.
Christ.
And the next one, I might leave it to you, Susie.
Yeah, your midguts.
Midguts?
Yeah, the midguts are the middle part of your alimentary canal.
OK, so at the end of that, John and Sarah have 12, Alan and Romesh have 17. Right. Now time for Alan and John to go head-to-head. John, your turn to pick the numbers.
Well, I'm a bit nervous now, cos Alan got it last time and I didn't. So what? How many big did you have? Two?
Two big and four small.
Four big, two small.
What the...? I've never seen you go maverick.
Never
you normally
this...
play it so safe.
Never been in this position before. I didn't know I cared until I started losing.
Ten. And nine. And the four large. 75. 50, 25,
jeez.
And 100.
Oh, I get it.
And the target? 364.
Oh, well, I mean, good luck, everyone. Your time starts now.
Oh.
Did you get it?
No, I didn't. No.
I've never seen anyone look as gormless as you halfway through that. OK, John, what did you get?
I think I got 365.
365? OK, how did you get 365?
25 plus 9.
25 plus 9, 34.
Times by 10.
Is 340.
And add the 25.
Yep, one away, 365. Well done.
OK. 7 points to John. Rachel, could it be done?
You could have said 25 times 10 is 250. Add 50 is 300. Divided by 75 is 4. And then 100 minus 9 is 91 and times them together.
It's all very well, but 200 years ago, we would have burnt you as a witch. OK, the scores at the moment, Alan and Ramesh have 17, John and Sarah have 19. Just in the lead. Yeah. Time now to go across the literary corner. John, what have you got for us?
Thank you, Jimmy! Now, it's the election special. So, elections mean polling stations. Polling stations mean schools. So I brought with me my old school tea towel. As you can see here, it's in a frame. That makes drying up the plates a tad difficult, but we manage. That's Cassandra. I remember in year four, she pissed herself, quite literally, when we were watching Cool Runnings. And I remember when she was escorted to the toilet, I remember thinking, this film ain't that funny, but I watched it a couple of weeks ago and... It is, yeah, it is. That's last week's lasagna. That's me there. I haven't changed a bit. I've grown a beard, obviously. My mum don't like my beard. She thinks people that have beards are hiding something. But I think if you don't grow a beard, aren't you just hiding a beard? You know what I mean? This bloke here, the main reason why I brought it. Ian, spelt with two eyes to go with the face. Look, the thing is, basically, I'm getting emotional here. Sorry, Sue. He was my best friend at school. We did everything together, you know. Rolling Satsumas down the street. Slapping brick walls till our palms were red. But his parents moved him away to America. We said we'd be pen pals, but 'twas the 90s. Didn't happen. And, Jimmy, I'm just... Look, the reason why I brought it on is... Ian, if you're out there, fella, or, you know, if there's anyone out there who knows him, can you just tell him from me? Bonjour, you know?
We've actually got a surprise for you this evening. All the way from America, John, Ian is here this evening.
No, fuck him! Jimmy, thank you so much. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank
John Cairns and Ian, everyone. And here is your teaser. The words are shit poll. The clue is the only way is up. That shit poll, the only way is up. See you after the break. Answer to the teaser, the words were shit poll. The clue was the only way is up. It was, of course, hilltops. Okay, on with the game. Alan and Ramesh, your turn to choose the letters.
Right.
Okay, you choose them, I'll write them down correctly.
consonant, consonant, consonant.
P. F. V.
And three vowels, please, love.
U. O.
Oh.
I.
I think I've got something.
Does it start with N?
Vowel. Oh no, what have I said?
You said vowel.
Yeah. yeah, I'll have a vowel. Go on then. And then I'll have a couple of consonants. Oh, look at this.
R.
Oh my God.
And B.
Okay, your time starts. Good luck with this. Shit. Now.
Thank you.
That's your worst nightmare, isn't it?
Right, what's everyone got? How many? Sarah, how many?
Five? Yeah.
OK, John?
Seven.
Oof.
Romesh, how many?
Got a safe four.
A safe four.
And that is all.
Alan?
I've got five.
OK, well, let's hear, Romesh, let's hear your safe four.
Rube. R-U-B-E.
Yeah.
Rube.
And it's in, yeah. Country bumpkin.
OK, Alan, your five?
Viper.
Like a what?
Like a snake.
You've got to say it's sexy, though, if you're going to say that.
Like a snake.
Sorry, was that... You were shooting for sexy, though, were you? Yeah. Oh, swing and a miss, I'd say.
Like a snake.
Hi, Sarah, yours?
My five is Fiver.
Fiver?
Like, as in a £5 note. Is it?
Yeah.
Fiver. John, you're seven for the points.
Covfef.
Covfef. Okay. Is this something that Trump tweeted?
Yes.
Covfef.
You'd say, despite the negative press, covfef. And the world says, do you know what? Maybe he's not mad.
So, well, 5 points for both teams. Oh. John Cairns. Good day's only better.
But there was a seven.
Mm-hmm.
Fouvier, a large, powerful, masculine...
Masculine?
Muscular.
Muscular dog.
I can't get enough of you.
Channel 4 can.
So, at the end of that, John and Sarah are in the lead with 24. Okay, on to our final numbers round. Okay, John, Sarah, pick your numbers.
One big one or two big ones?
Two.
Two? This is a democracy. How many do you want?
Oh, two.
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 Yeah.
Four big. Two big, four small.
Right. Two big, four little. And this time, they are 10, 5, 9, 7. The big ones, 25 and 75. And this target, 338.
Okay, and your time starts now. OK, so the target was 338. Alan, did you get it?
Nothing.
Nothing?
Nothing.
It's all right. Do you know what? You take it easy. Romesh, maths teacher. Romesh, did you get it, 338?
I got close. I got 40.
Sarah, did you get it?
No, I got 330.
Well, pretty close. What about you, John?
I got 340.
Ooh.
How did you get 340, John?
75 minus 25.
50.
Times 7.
350.
Minus 10.
340.
7 points to John. Rachel.
Yes.
Could this be done?
Yes. If you say 75 minus 25 again for 50, and then 10 minus 9 is 1, take it away for 49, times that by 7 for 343, and take away the 5.
OK, the scores at the moment, Alan and Romesh have 22, John and Sarah have 31, so it's going to be a crucial countdown conundrum today. Fingers on buzzers. You ready?
Don't fuck this up. Don't touch it until I tell you to touch it.
I tell you what, he said that before.
In your dreams, love, in your dreams.
Fingers on buzzers, it's time for today's crucial countdown conundrum. Your time starts now.
Positives.
Well, let's have a look. Oh, he's done it, he's done it. What just happened there?
He just flick that dog shit?
I wanted to grab, grab something like it was a trophy and the nearest thing was a dog shit.
You could go blind!
You chose a dog shit over, like, hugging me.
So the final scores are Alan and Ramesh have 22, but tonight's winners with 41, John and Sarah! Congratulations, you're now the proud owners of this, the Countdown Portable Voting Booth! Thanks to all our panelists, our wonderful studio audience, and to all of you watching at home. That's it from us. Good night.
Join me, David Mitchell, and Richard Osman, plus a host of guests after this short break as we look ahead to a night of high drama, shocks, successes, failures, and graphs. First up, in just a few minutes, is the exit poll.